Jedi from Malachor 5.
If she's one of the Jedi, hell, we can't have her walking around here. She'll... well, I don't know what she'll do.
I thought all the Jedi were wiped out in the Civil War, weren't they?
Guess they missed one. But it gets better. I did some checking, and that bounty on Nar Shaddaa is still alive.
What? You want to sell the Jedi to the Exchange? Korda, have you been chewing spice?
Look, you know how big that bounty is? That Jedi's our ticket off this rock.
Korda, there's no way the officers will go for that. They'll lock us up for sure.
Then we'll improvise.
Thank you. Yeah, picking up some strange readings. What are you doing down there? The containment fields in the mining tunnels are shutting down. You need to get out of there before they vent fuel to the surface of the asteroid through the tunnels. I may be able to keep it contained until you get the turbo lift to the fuel depot, but not for much longer. I'm locking down the turbo lift to the administration section now to keep the blast from spreading. If you've got anything left to do down there, make it quick, because where you are is going to get real hot, real soon.
Thank you. pleasure to see you alive, Master. Provided my receptors are not off focus. How may I be of assistance? Proud answer. I am an HK Series Protocol Droid Master, skilled in transorganic relations and communications. This month has been responsible for the facilitation of communications and termination of hostilities across the galaxy. I am fluent in over 6,000 forms of communication, and am also capable of nuances of expression ranging from irony to veiled threats. Irritated explanation. That question has been looping through my query module with alarming frequency, Master, and no satisfactory answer has been forthcoming. As a result, I have chosen instead to turn my efforts to answering the question as to how I may depart this drifting disaster area as quickly as possible. Answer. It is only a matter of time before a ship or freighter docks with the Paragus facility. When that occurs, we shall depart this place forever. Condescending retraction. I believe you will do your best, Master. This facility would have to be nailed down with a droid-level precision to prevent your escape. Placating answer. Oh, of course, Master. I shall endeavor not to forget such descriptors in the future. If I do, I assure you, it is merely a result of memory damage I have suffered since our arrival. Of course, Master. How may I be of assistance? Hesitant answer. A T3 utility droid would be a common sight in this facility. It is indeed curious that I have not seen many since my arrival. However, I feel I must inform you that, droid prejudice aside, T3 models exhibit excessive individualism when not routinely memory wiped. This individualism can become such a nuisance that even a droid such as myself is tempted to reduce them to their base components, if not crush them into slag. But enough of my seemingly irrelevant tangent. Where did you leave the droid, Master? That would logically be the best place to look. Answer. Then that would explain why such a T3 unit isn't here, Master. I believe my photoreceptors are functioning adequately enough to verify that. Of course, Master. How may I be of assistance? Accessing memory. Yes. I believe you have asked this question before, Master. Let me see if I can recite the answer I provided the first time. Oh, yes. It was, where did you... Answer. Of course. Pitying answer. Oh, that is unfortunate, Master. The hangar is sealed behind a containment field. It would be impossible to open it. Answer. Only the Paragus administration officer would have such codes, Master. If he hasn't already been murdered in an unfortunate accident, then he is trapped in the dormitory section, which has been effectively cut off from the facility by explosives. Theory. You could walk across the surface of the asteroid to the dormitory airlock, but such a route would be extremely hazardous, and I do not wish to see you damaged. Master, continued exploration of this facility may place you in unnecessary danger. I encourage you to return to the medical bay and wait for retrieval from a vessel that is no doubt on the way, even as we continue this pointless conversation. Weary resignation. Very well, Master, but there is very little that I can do. You see, the airlock is sealed by a code. Correction. Oh, I already possess the code, Master, but I am afraid that it will do you no good. Condescending explanation. Master, the console governing the droid maintenance area and the airlock, his voice printed, musing. In the last days of his life, the maintenance officer was quite careful about voice protocols, bordering on paranoid obsession. Conjecture. I suspect once he realized something was wrong in the facility, he voice-locked the droid bay functions, a prudent measure, but in the end, he met the same fate as the rest of the organics. Condescending explanation. Oh, yes, Master. The code is Maintenance Control Voice Print ID R1B5. But unless the maintenance officer speaks the code, it is useless. Answer. Master, you cannot. You are trapped here just as I am. There is nothing to do except patiently wait for whatever the future has in store for us.
Greeting.
It is.
Recitation. Of course, for that. Condescending explanation. Master, the console governing the droid maintenance area and the airlock, is voice printed, musing. In the last days of his life, the maintenance officer was conjecture. I suspect one. Explanation. Yes, Master. Many consoles have voice recognition sensors built into their systems so that only selected individuals can unlock them. Condescending explanation. Answer, Matt. Of course. Answer. I heard his dying screams as the droids he tended turned on him, mining him like a piece of asteroid rock. Recitation. Oh, yes, Master. The record of his last moments were...
Five droids burning through the outer door. They're forcing their way into the bay. Please, someone that... Oh, no, they're through! Oh, my leg! They're burning through my leg! Stop!
Addendum. His remaining attempts at communication are variations in decibel, Master, ranging from frenzied screams to gibbering inarticulate attempts to beg for his life. Recitation. Oh, yes, Master. The record of his last moments were...
Five droids. Burning...
Addendum. His remaining attempts at communication are very... Objection. Master, to commit such an act would be in violation of the ethics programming most droids are believed to possess. I am afraid there is nothing that can be done. Irritated objection. Master, there is nothing wrong with my communications functionality. I will prove it. A recitation.
Maintenance control voice print ID R1B5.
There. Was that sufficient, Master?
Finish the sonic imprint sensor prototype for the mining droids. Everyone knows they need an upgrade. The sensor should allow me to issue voice commands to them rather than manually adjusting their routine each time the mining specifications change. I've been keeping the sensor in the maintenance workshop for the time being. I wanted to test it first by recording and playing back some simple voice commands.